there is a verbal sunnah that is supposed to be said straight after al-witr. And this was narrated by Abd al-Rahman ibn Abza radiyallahu anhu, that the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, when he concluded salat al-witr, whether you prayed it 3 rak'at or 1 rak'ah, whether in Ramadan or outside of Ramadan, whether you pray it in the masjid or at home, that he sallallahu alayhi wa sallam would say, Subhan al-Malik al-Quddus, and he would say it 3 times. And on the 3rd time, he would prolong the alif in Subhan. So he would say, Subhan al-Malik al-Quddus, Subhan al-Malik al-Quddus, Subhan al-Malik al-Quddus, and he would say it aloud. That is the sunnah. And there is also another narration in where he would add to this, and this is the narration of Ubay ibn Ka'ab radiyallahu anhu. He would say, رَبِّ الْمَلَائِكَةِ وَالْرُوحِ. So he will add to what I have already said to you. Therefore, he would say, سُبْحَانَ الْمَلِكِ الْقُدُّوسِ رَبِّ الْمَلَائِكَةِ وَالْرُوحِ, and 3 times. So sometimes you can just say, سُبْحَانَ الْمَلِكِ الْقُدُّوسِ 3 times. And other times you can say, سُبْحَانَ الْمَلِكِ الْقُدُّوسِ رَبِّ الْمَلَائِكَةِ وَالْرُوحِ. And so what this means is, سُبْحَانَ الْمَلِكِ الْقُدُّوسِ, glory be to al-Malik, the king, subhanahu wa ta'ala. Al-Quddus, the pure one, the one who is free and disassociates from all imperfection and flaws and so on, because Allah Azza wa Jal is perfect, subhanahu wa ta'ala. Rabbi al-Malaikati wa al-Ruh, the Lord of all the angels, and the Lord of al-Ruh, which is another name for Jibreel alayhi salam.